All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios. And joining us now in studio is Paul Mann, the CEO of Alchemist, and Joel Semczyszyn. He is the CEO of Rubikon Blockchain, which makes an interesting platform called the CertiCraft. And we'll get to that in just a second. But gentlemen, first, thanks very much for being here, to both of you. Paul, tell me a little bit about why Rubikon and Alchemist. Why the connection?
Well, we were talking about technology in the beginning, and yeah. I think technology is the enabler here. We've got a situation where the cannabis industry right now in Canada and other places is suffering a real shortage of supply. And the big LPs, whether we like it or not, are having their challenges making these massive grows work. There's definitely a shortage of supply. And what that supply is going to be filled from, I believe, is from these smaller craft companies that have been around for a while. Under the new micro licenses that are being considered, you know, people are going to be able to grow up to 600 kilograms a year. But there's going to be hundreds of those. And with our Odyssey platform that we talked about, the idea of licensing these people is the first step. Once you've got them licensed, to keep them compliant and to keep them in a technology platform that automatically manages to keep them compliant is really what we were looking for. And again, looking at various technologies, when we met Joel and the team, what they were doing and how they were doing it, and the fact that they had grants from the government to build this really, I think, was the gel that we needed.
Yeah, Joel, tell us about CertiCraft. And you mentioned you did get grants from the Canadian government to build this.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. There's a contribution from the IRAP, NRC. It's a project that assists with industrial research and new developments.
Okay, so tell us how blockchain works with this system.
Yeah, absolutely. So first step, how blockchain works is it's a distributed ledger technology. And what that means is that whenever you're gathering data, instead of keeping it on one centralized server that one person could control, instead that data is held on 10,000 or 100,000 different computers. So that way, that data is substantially more secure and much more difficult to manipulate if you were to be a malicious actor of any sort.
Right.
So why that makes sense in supply chain or what we do with CertiCraft is that we're gathering all of this product information. And then if we are taking all of this and putting it on the blockchain, that means that if you are an international country, let's say Germany, and you're wanting to purchase hundreds of millions of dollars worth of cannabis for your medicinal program, you want to rely on the data that you are given to make that massive purchasing decision. Why wouldn't you choose the data that is held immutable with the blockchain?
Right. And so how was the fit with what Alchemist does? Where did you see the fit with them?
So CertiCraft, first and foremost, we make cannabis compliance easy. So for all of these different producers, they're stoners typically, they're green thumbs, they're not technologically inclined.
Right.
They just want to be able to grow, so we just handle the rest. We use a software platform that makes it very easy for them to stay compliant while focusing on their grow. And for the rest of the Alchemist system, we take all of that data that we're gathering and we feed it directly into either the retail offerings of Aqua or, yeah.
The other supplies and other programs that you use.
Yes.
And that's the key, right, Paul, is that you've talked about in the past that you have to make it easy and you have to make it seamless for people and you have to get people to know about it. That's the third thing of this whole thing. So does that add into what he's talking about as far as your business model is concerned?
Absolutely. I've been in the technology space for about 20, 30 years now.
Yeah.
And when we were working in cryptography and in authentication systems, we used to keep talking about making products idiot-proof. And my CTO used to say, but Paul, they keep making better idiots. So what really resonated with me with these guys is they said, you know, people in this industry, they're high most of the time. They hate technology. They don't want to have to go from ledger to ledger or from tab to tab. And they don't want to stop growing and get on with the business of managing the data and or managing the supply chain. So when they said we made this stoner proof, it sort of clicked with me in the idiot proof story that I said, because now you're really having a step-by-step process that they produce that when you get to this step, you actually can't go to the next step unless this is right. And it instantly at that point plugs into the blockchain, as Joel said. And the beauty of this that I love is that everything is driven through RFID, IoT. So all the peripherals where you're weighing, where you're moving, they're all plugged into the software. So it literally is a stoner-proof system that allows you to go from the track and trace. So the minute you put your seed in that pot to the minute you've packaged it and sent it to a distributor or a dispensary or wherever, we can, as he said, it's immutable now because every step of the way it's plugged into the blockchain.
You mentioned micro-licenses, and I just want to talk to you both a bit more about micro-licenses and just how big can this, you know, system get? You know, we talk about there's a lot of companies that are trying to do cannabis, but is it more the micro-licenses where you see the potential for the biggest growth?
Well, when it comes to big LPs, yeah, they've already got the infrastructure to bring in their own people.
Sure.
They're doing what they're doing, and they're doing it the way they want to.
Right.
The little guys, the micro people who are really producing artisan products, they really don't have, A, the technical ability, B, the knowledge on how to manage it. But it, as I said previously, in British Columbia alone, we've been told there's over 1,400 people who would fit into that micro-license space. So with our platform, helping people to order to get that licensing step, then helping them to stay compliant, and then helping them with the POS and the inventory management. That's really what the technology platform was about. But I've said, people have come to me and said, okay, you've got this great technology platform, but if nobody uses it, what use is it to you?
Yeah.
So really we're saying to the authorities and we're saying to the small growers, we'll take this headache off your plate, because now how much money would you be spending on manpower documenting everything you do to stay compliant? Mm-hmm. If that takes that off of your plate, now that saving that you've got, only a fraction of that is going towards the cost of the software. So we do feel that that micro group is really where the future for us is.
Additionally, another thing about micro-licenses within the space here in Canada is that they are unable to, these being the micro cultivators, they are unable to sell directly to the government due to the licensing structure that the Cannabis Act has laid out. So they must sell to other full-size licensed producers or processors. And what doesn't exist is software that properly facilitates these relationships. So we have created a wholesale marketplace that makes it so we're able to take this information that we're gathering automatically already for compliance and seamlessly list these products up onto this B2B wholesale marketplace, facilitate relationships here in Canada.
And those relationships now with the smaller growers, we aggregate those smaller growers. As I said, there's almost 1,400 of those around in British Columbia alone. If a few hundred of those are aggregated in a platform, that allows the people to, as I said, handle that supply shortage issue.
Joel, there was a lot of talk about blockchain about a year and a half ago, maybe even 2 years ago, about how it was going to be the technology that will save us all. The talk has really died down, but I have a feeling that it's starting to creep back in because of the use of blockchain within cannabis. Are you hearing that as well?
Yes, I am. There is definitely a recovery within the blockchain space. It's just taken a lot longer than people were originally anticipating. But if you think about the inception of the internet, we weren't all using internet within our homes for decades after its inception. Massive disruptive technology changes take time, and they take good applications. And blockchain has two key applications. One is distributed financial systems, such as Bitcoin. Fantastic application. Ethereum, another great example. Second, supply chain management. Being able to keep the data about products that you or governments will be consuming safe.
It is fascinating stuff, and it's you know, right down the alley of combining all the technology together and how important it is for this growing industry in Canada.
Absolutely. One point I'd like to raise here is that you know, the blockchain cryptocurrency explosion. We're hearing all these different cryptocurrencies are now getting hacked or having problems. I don't see, and I know that Joel can speak to this as well, but I don't necessarily see people trading or buying cannabis using cryptocurrencies. That's why really we've looked at the whole supply chain so that we can handle the cash management at the other side electronically as opposed to cash.
Right. So
the blockchain part of it is really where I think the future of blockchain is. I'm not a person who's necessarily sold on cryptocurrencies, but we're sort of separating those two. And we're simply saying, if you're on the blockchain, it's for authentication and immutability. As far as cryptocurrencies are concerned, if you choose to use those, that's a different issue. But we really want to use the blockchain so that it parlays. But when it comes to purchasing, sales, people are going to use plastic and cash because that's what they know today. Yeah. So we're really, I wanted to make sure that nobody gets the impression that we're trying to get into trading on the crypto side as well. Yeah. It's purely the fact that this process is validated using that ledger spread, as Joel explained.
Yeah, and that's why there's, as you mentioned, there's two. the Bitcoin one part, but the second part is what the key to this is.
Yeah, definitely. Absolutely.
Cool. Well, great to see you and great to meet you as well. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Steve. As well.
All right, it's Paul Mann, the CEO of Alchemist, and Joel Semczyszyn, the CEO of Rubikon Blockchain.